estudiants, Xavier Martínez-Fernández, que ha estat dirigit pels professors Xavier Franch i Claudia Ayala. Quan vulguis.
Good morning. My name is Xavier Martínez, and I'm going to present our thesis proposal, which is a framework for software graphic architecture analysis and review. I divide the presentation in four parts. First, I will start with an introduction. Then I will discuss the state of the art of related work. The most important part is the thesis proposal. I will finish with the working plan. So let's start with the introduction to see some background of software architecture. Every software system or application has its own software architecture, which is the set of a structure which comprises the software elements needed to reason about the system, the relations among them, and properties of both. This is the simplest definition of software architecture, but the normal big organization or enterprises nowadays have a wide portfolio of applications, and they wonder if they have the need of managing the size of complexity of this many software system, and they also need to reduce the cost in the development and maintenance of the software system. So to deal with these two questions, they use software reference architecture that then became the baselines for all these many software systems. So if we use the metaphor that the software architecture of a software system is like the structure of a house, then we are not making the job of an architect, but the job of a city planner who thinks in all the houses of a city. And then software architectures have two main goals, which is to facilitate the common elements for the applications, so for instance, the road, the swimming pool, and also to standardize and make homogeneous developments of the houses. There are many examples in the industry about software-defined architectures. Some of them target a technological domain, for instance, the Open Group Consortium, which has a software-defined architecture for service-oriented systems, and then they facilitate the design of this kind of system. About the, there are also other software-defined architectures which target a business domain, and they can be either for many organizations, like the AutoSAR reference architecture, that helps to the interoperability of the software which is on the cars, and then if a car manufacturer builds some element or some software for a car, this can be reused in other car brands. And there are also reference architectures for single organization and specific needs, like the one of NASA, and for instance, just to make data earth science systems. So they standardize all these developments. So software reference architecture, we can say that they are widely recognized and used in practice, but there is still some gaps that hamper its successful adoption. We identify two of them. The first one is the lack of support for deciding on the adoption of software reference architecture. So imagine that you are the CIO of an organization and you have read about the benefits and the drawbacks of software reference architectures, and you are wondering if a software reference architecture would be good for your organization. then you need to justify the investment to the executives or the managers. And what they understand is the monetary terms, in which moment they can get profit of the use of a reference architecture, how many applications do they need to be based on the reference architecture to start to have benefits. So it is needed to make a financial analysis. And also, there is lack of support for the design and the review of software reference architecture. So if you are a developer or a software architect, there are no clear guidelines about the elements that comprise a software reference architecture or which quality attributes do they enforce. So we study the state of the art in these two areas. First, about software reference architecture economics, we saw that there is no research up to our knowledge about the economic model for software reference architectures, but there is a strong base in related areas. For instance, for product line architecture adoption, there are many economic models which define cost and benefit factors. They are very similar product line architectures to software reference architectures. So we think that we can reuse them. Economic driven software architecture analysis method help to make architectural decision based on the return on investment that they provide, and then select those architectural decisions that give a highest return on investment. But however, they are too generalized and they do not focus in specifics of software reference architectures. And in case that we cannot find there enough metrics, we can use general software metrics basic ones like lines of code or design structure matrix to define new ones. Still, many of these methods are not validated in industry, and sometimes they are also unrealistic and they do not provide guidelines for its application in the industry. So we will try to deal with it. And in the other part, for supporting the design and the review of software reference architectures, even that there were no methods for the evaluation of software architectures and a few words about how to design a software reference architecture, they are not normally adopted in practice. And we think that the problem is that there is no evidence about how to select and use this kind of methods, so practitioners see them difficult to apply. So we want to harvest the vision from all the stakeholders around a software reference architecture project. And as one author was mentioning, there is a need of recent research that proposed means to design and evaluate software reference. So with this state of the art, what is needed to be done now? We aim to create an economic model for software reference architectures, not starting from scratch, and try to reuse previous research from product line architecture, software architecture decision making context, and generic software metrics. And to support the design and review of software reference architectures, we want to give some guidelines to support the selection and use of these methods. So with this, we go to the thesis proposal. Our main goal in this research is to support organizations, as I said, to decide on the adoption of software reference architectures, and also to support the design and review of software reference architecture. So we divide this general goal into research questions. The first one has a quantitative output, and the second one a qualitative result. So let's see the first research question, which is if it's worth to invest on the adoption of a software reference architecture. That means for an organization, if they should make the strategic move of basing all the developments and maintenance of applications in a software reference architecture. We divide this research question in four sub-research questions. The first one is how are they used in practice to understand the context, the stakeholders that are involved in this kind of projects, the vendor organizations, acquisition organizations. The second one, to deal with this problem that current economic models are not applied in the industry, we want to define realistic metrics and that are very easy to apply in the industry without any extra force. So we are checking the available data that organizations do have to calculate these cost and benefits. The third one is to define the cost and benefit factors that we have when adopting a software reference architecture. And then they will help us to calculate the return on investment for the organization and to make payback analysis, investment analysis, and many types of financial analysis types to help managers and executives in the organizations to understand the software reference architecture benefits. And on the other hand, we want to support the design and review of software reference architectures with evidence. And we identified five main key issues or relevant aspects that may help practitioners. The first one is to check how different stakeholders, the software reference architecture developers, the developers that use the architecture, perceive the potential benefits and drawbacks of reference architectures. The second one is to provide some guidelines about the elements that compose a software reference architecture, which would help the design, and also to see how these elements can be reused for future projects. The third one, the quality attributes that they do enforce, such as interoperability, reuse, so that they can understand the characteristic of the project. Then to propagate the architectural decisions that they do, we will study the documentation of this kind of project. Last but not least, the supportive technologies such as the methodology that they use for software development, the tools normally used, or technologies for databases, business layers, and so on. So these are the two research questions that we have in this thesis. So let's see how we are going to deal with this problem. The approach that we selected is the empirical software methods. Basically, we have two challenges, which are to calculate the return on investment of software reference architecture adoption and to increase the evidence on the key issues that are important for the design and review of architectures. We are going to do two kinds of empirical assessments, quantitative and qualitative. And with that, we will have two main results, which are the economic model and increased evidence about the relevant aspects. This will help us to corroborate or refuse or even to add new knowledge to the software reference architecture theory. And on the other hand, if we use empirical methods such as surveys or case studies, we will analyze the lessons learned while conducting them, and also the empirical theory will be different. So this is maybe too abstract, so let's go to the current paradigm that in which we are working. We are performing action research at Everis, which is a consulting firm based on Spain. And all this work is under the Catedral HPC project. So we saw that they have a similar context as I was defining in the beginning. They are the software reference architecture vendors for many big businesses such as banks, insurance companies, public administrations. And what these organizations need to manage is also a wide portfolio of applications. For instance, a bank, they provide applications for the mobile phone, another for the ATM, e-banking for the internet. Or also the people who is working in the office of the bank have their own application. So to standardize all these developments and interoperate them, whatever is offering a software reference architecture that is the baseline of all these applications. So what we do is to observe how these projects are being done. We get the feedback on how they are improving this kind of developments and give them the feedback from our studies so that they can continue to improve their software reference architectures. So the main core of the thesis proposal is the framework that we envisage. We are going to conduct four type of empirical studies. In the left side, with the empirical studies to answer the research question one, and in the right side, the empirical studies to answer the research questions two. They are divided in two steps, understand and evaluate, and I will explain them one by one. The first one is the survey to check existing value-driven data in organizations. The objective here is to see the data that organizations have for calculating the cost and benefits of software-driven architectures, and we'll contact with five software reference architecture projects and two types of stakeholders, the software architects that create the reference architecture and five application builders that are building applications on top of the architecture. For data collection, we will use online questionnaires and for analysis, frequency analysis. Now that we understand how to calculate the cost and benefits, we will apply in two cases studies the economic model to calculate the return on investment. The objective here is to make financial analysis and the organizations by when are they going to realize benefits, or how many applications do they need to create to start to have benefits, and so on. So we are going to do it in two software reference architecture projects. And for the data collection, we will use tools to gather metrics from time tracking for the cost and effort metrics, some quality software metrics to calculate the benefits. For the data analysis, we plan to create an economic model. So now the other part of the framework, the right part, for supporting the design and review of software reference architectures. We are going to conduct a survey to understand the impact of using a software reference architecture. We contact nine software reference architectural projects, and we have in total 28 participants, nine software architects, nine software reference architectural developers, and 10 application builders. And for the data collection, we used face-to-face interviews and online questionnaires. And we are going to use quality analysis methods. And then this will help us to understand how to select and use existing methods for the design and review of software architecture. So this is the global picture of the framework. and let's see how we will create it. So there are two stages in our research. The first one is to shape the framework, which is the formative stage. So we will conduct the empirical studies, and we will be improving the framework iteratively until no further improvement is detected. And then we will reach the at the end of the thesis, the summative stage, in which we are going to apply these empirical studies a last time in order to validate them. As all empirical studies, we also have some threats to validity that we need to control. The construct validity means to which degree the methods are really measuring what it's needed to see. So we apply guidelines for empirical software engineering methods, and we study relevant aspects for theory and practice. About the internal validity, we try to see all the different domains of software reference architectures, and we ask Everest to give us different projects with success or failures. We also try to facilitate the answer from contacted stakeholders. For instance, in the face-to-face interviews, we add additional questions for triangulation purposes. Or in the online questionnaires, the interviews always have the possibility to add additional comments if they decide. And we have some mitigation strategies to ensure the quality of the studies, such interviews recording, analysis from many resources to avoid the subjective bias, direct access to collect the metrics without any intervention from the company, and so on. Maybe the most difficult threat to validity to control is the external validity. And since we are working just in one organization, in Everest, people may wonder if these results can be generalized for other software reference architecture projects. So in every moment, we try to enable the replication of the studies, and we facilitate the instruments that we are using and define the context abstract enough so that it can be generalized in other contexts. And finally, reliability. We are analyzing the results many of us to avoid subjective bias, and also we try to corroborate reviews and new knowledge from theory. So let's go to the last part of the presentation, which is the working plan. We define seven general tasks. The first one is the state of the art and state of the practice in software reference architectures, economic models, and empirical software engineering with actual activities, the initial stages, and maintain an up-to-date state of the art. The second task is the definition of the framework for supporting the design, the adoption, and the review of software reference architectures. The third one is the first empirical study, which is a survey to see existing value-driven data in organizations. The fourth one, the economic model that we are going to apply in two organizations. The fifth one, a survey to understand the relevant aspect about software reference architectures. And then at the end, I plan to write the thesis and design the presentation of the thesis. So this task, three of them are general honorary thesis, like the state of the art and writing and presenting the thesis. And let's see how they the rest answer to the research questions. The task two, the framework, cope with both pre-research questions, the quantitative and the qualitative. And we presented a preliminary version of the framework at the SLO workshop and in a technical report. About the task which target the research question one. We conducted the economic model in a real software reference architecture project, and we published the results in the International Conference of Software Reuse and in a technical report. And then we are starting to analyze the data from the qualitative surveys, and we presented in the European Conference of Software Architecture preliminary results about the benefits and drawbacks of software reference architecture adoption. So the timeline of the presentation, the thesis will last 4 years. I started in October of 2011, so now I'm almost in the middle of the thesis. Let's see it in more detail in the Gantt diagram. First, we have the state of the art, in which I was focused in the beginning, and we will maintain an up-to-date state of the art. The taxonomy is the definition of the framework. So we have the definition and then formative states to improve it and shape it with the conduction of formative studies. And at the end, we have a summative states. Tags 3, 4, and 5 were the empirical studies 1, 2, and 3 that will be fit the formative stage of the framework, and then at the end we will write and present the thesis. And this has been all, so now there are time for questions.
Thank you very much. We begin the question with the secretary, Oscar.
So thank you, Silverio, for this nice presentation. First of all, say that it was easy to read your document. There was a clear definition of the problem, a clear statement of what we try to do, a very exhaustive state of the art, and then I think that all the tasks you have to conduct in order to finish your PhD are quite clear right now, so you know what to do, and I think it's quite a feasible scenario what you're presenting here, 2 years more with all the stuff you have to do for finishing. So just a few questions. I'm not expert on this, so expect some global questions, let's say. First of all, let's say that it could have been great if at the beginning, with all the definitions, you could have put some examples, because these definitions are full of words that are quite generic.
Yeah.
So, for example, me coming from the database perspective, I was understanding something completely different. So I was reading and then I realized that by element or per property, you are understanding a different thing. So, I know they are extracted from books and they are very well-established definitions, but it was difficult to follow some of them.
Well, maybe the first definition by elements of software architecture, for instance, we understand the tiers of layers of the software architecture, how it is structured. A difference of reference architectures with respect to reference models is that they also integrate software elements that can be reused in the applications. Well, yeah, I could have put more samples in the introduction.
In the end, it was okay. So I understand.
But you mean in the book or in the?
No, not here in the end. The presentation, I think, it was pretty great.
Okay.
It was at the beginning mostly that there are a lot of definitions, a lot of definitions started from books and so on.
Well, I saw it and that's why I included the samples later in the presentation.
Well, another maybe naive question, but it's not clear to me, is that at some point you present quite few business case analyses for considering how could you assess the impact of a system in a company, but you just select the return of investment and you don't say much why the other ones are not very interesting for you.
Yeah, well, we are not only trying to calculate the return on investment. But it's like the most famous one and the one that everybody understands. In the economic model, provide means to make other types of analysis, like cost benefit analysis that would be very related to return on investment, but other ones as breakpoint analysis, break even analysis, that it's like a kind of analysis that tries to calculate the number of applications that are needed to start to have benefits, or by if we are adopting a software open architecture, so calculate in 1 year and a half the investment will be payback. We will recover the expenses. So there are also sensitivity analysis to check the accuracy of the economic model. So there are a few of them, not only with our investment, in which these people is well, in which that we need to perform these types of financial analysis to justify better the investment.
Okay, so somehow you're considering the others as well.
Yeah.
Maybe this is not clear in the document then, because I understood it was mainly cost-based, I don't know if it was a problem, but
yeah.
I understood this way. Okay, the other thing is that somehow your thesis is grounded somewhere in the middle between business and software engineering, right? Hmm. So, from my point of view, when I was reading this, it was how to evaluate the impact of what you are doing also in the business part. I mean, you are also checking references regarding the business aspects that could be interesting for you, and you coming from the computer science world, how can you be sure that what you are doing is enough to assess the impact of this part?
Yeah, indeed, in the beginning I was quite lost, but the problem is that in the economic side, what they describe is the concepts, but then when you see this a software project, you don't know how to apply this type of analysis. The question was if I give feedback to the economic side of it.
Maybe if you got some ideas or feedback, or you can guarantee somehow that the impact of your thesis also will make sense for the business side.
Well, this is the main goal. This is the main goal, that it needs to make sense for the business side. But the gap here is to define the, to be able to create this kind of analysis that are accurate, that do really make sense also for technical people. So, from 10 applications or from 3 applications, we will start to have benefits. But it's like the union of both sides. But let's say that the one that rules, that the ones that say how it need to be done is the business part.
I will go in this line in the rest of my questions, because this is mainly, I guess, from my point of view, the main threat of your thesis. So, for example, you define two big high-level research questions, okay? So in the first one, for me, it's very related to business goals. And here, for example, it's not clear to me how the business model of the organization can be considered inside. Because for some of the questions that you have here, I don't remember them now, but for example, which commonly available data the organizations have to quantitatively calculate the cost and benefits, for example, these kind of things. I guess that this is very tied to the business model or the way that the organization works. Right? So somehow it should depend on this kind of formalization that they internally will have to formalize the business processes and so on.
Well, yeah, indeed, every organization has its own data. So, what we try to do, for instance, in this research question, is to find the data that most of our organizations do have. And for instance, the two pillars, the two main things, that metrics that we are collecting, is the four metrics. Our impression, well, not only from the survey, but let's say that the survey cannot be generalized to other organizations, because it was done just in Everis, but our impression is that they are all organizations have some type of control over the time amount of work that employees do invest. So from there, from time tracking activities, we can calculate the cost and effort of the activities in software and architecture projects. So from the source code, we try to see the reuse metric, like how many lines of code are being reused, or the dependencies between the modules to try to calculate the maintenance cost. So let's say that what we are trying to do is to define realistic metrics that can be applied, because in other economic models they had great ideas, but they are very difficult to be used in other companies. So sometimes it's better to make it a little bit simpler in order to be applied. That's
so we are trying to somehow formalize all this know-how that it's running in the company, and try to formalize somehow as the part of the computer science software engineering. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. And about the second question, I think it mainly relies on surveys, right?
Yeah.
But also here the same kind of question arises. It's what about the representative of the people being surveyed? Because in the end, you know that if you, for example, are only serving people from Everest, you are somehow biased. Because so I was checking the numbers that you had there, and I think I don't know if you wish to be overfitting Everest or whoever. Because, well, this is another question. Is you said two organizations here, X and Y. So Are they set or is?
Well, they know them, but for confidentiality issues, we don't say them.
Okay.
But yeah, this is the, let's say, the main drawback of our approach, because the idea work would be to replicate these three studies, not in Everest, but in other organizations, so that we can compare the results and then generalize them. But even that we are only working with Everest, since they have many client organizations, these projects, even some of the projects are being done out of Spain. So they are for different client organizations, and it's not that narrow, that specific, the focus. But yeah, what we are trying to do in other time is to facilitate the instruments that we use, or to define the context so that not only us but other people, if they are interested, can replicate the study and see if it can be generalized. Yeah, we cannot say this is these results can be used for all organizations that have a software architecture. But we try to provide the means. If we do further work, further studies, to be able to do so.
So it's a first step towards having something else.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's everything from my side. Thank you, Ben.
Thank you. I'm far from this topic. My knowledge is not very precise. But I did a look on your definition of software reference architecture,
yeah.
And I like it very much, the last sentence, that in some way try to solve the Oscar problem. All of this must be supported by unified, unambiguous, and widely understood domain terminology. And my question is, in order to avoid any kind of ambiguity, do you plan to use some kind of formal method?
Well, indeed, this is the most difficult thing to achieve, because in every organization they have their own terminology. There are many terms of architecture, business architecture, information architecture, enterprise architecture. So it's very difficult, this last part. And I think that it can be right now only achieved in an organization that tries to do so. This is also the, let's say, the, one of the main drawbacks of software reference architectures. Because, for instance, in this example of AutoSAR reference architecture for the automotive domain, they were, every car manufacturer was making its own cars, and they couldn't interact with each other, or they couldn't use a piece or an element in another car. So I do not plan to create any formal method, but we can see in the studies that software reference architectures try to deal with this attempt to unify all this, to reduce the ambiguity and to standardize all the developments.
I'm very with you, also with your comment. But let me remind you that enterprise is accounting, and you could apply, in principle, the same argument to money. Mm-hmm. I say that without every enterprise has its our local view of money, they deal with that. But at the end, you have accounting, and in principle, you can understand the accounting. I mean by that I'm not saying that's easy, but in some way this could be possible, because otherwise there is no. And I'm saying that for money, mm-hmm. they arrive to that.
Yeah.
Perhaps not for software, but for money is very important for enterprises.
Yeah, that's indeed the first part of our work.
And just a question, that you say that you would like to calculate the ROI. Do you have some concrete example?
So it's not in the presentation, because okay. I just put the proposal. But in these two publications, what we did is in a software architecture project, we take metrics from applications and we calculated, for instance, well, if I remember well the results, it was a 3-year program of a software architecture, and they were reaching the break-even point. They were starting to have a positive return investment almost in the one after 1 year and a half, and with 7 applications. So this is the sample of a financial analysis to see how many applications an organization need to start to have profit, and by how much time do they need to have it, pretty much.
Okay. Just two more short things. The first one, as I'm not really familiar with your topic, I will ask you to summarize in just a short sentence. What is the main goal of your PhD?
The main work is okay. Software and architectures have many benefits for developers, but if they don't know how to justify to the managers, they cannot adopt it. So that's what we are trying to help, how they can justify this adoption.
Okay.
Because now it's very difficult for them. They cannot say you are going to have benefits in that time.
And just a comment is, as you know, the papers and publications are really important nowadays. I encourage you to try to publish in good journals having high impact index, because the university is just counting, and it's important for the program, and I think it's important for all of us to have a nice paper with high impact, nice journals with high impact. And that is not so easy for people working in computer science, at least in some topics, but right.
Yeah.
perfect.
First of all, I would like to congratulate you and your advisors for your work. I think it's a good proposal. And in my opinion, the document is well structured and well explained. I think that the publications that you mentioned in the document are contextualized in the activities that you will perform for your thesis development. And I have only two questions. The first question is about in the document you point out the similarities and differences between software product lines and reference architectures. Yeah. In fact, you have in the state of the art you have a section reviewing economic models for software product lines. But in your proposal, when you define your research questions, I didn't see how this knowledge about software product lines contributes to your goals.
Well, it's not explicitly said in the research question, but it was very useful to see. As I said in the beginning, I was very lost because it's difficult to calculate accurately this kind of thing, this kind of financial analysis. And when we started to see how it could be done is when we saw how it was done for product line architecture. So they are similar since, for instance, they have common elements to be reusing on applications, and they, well, maybe the variability is not that similar. But for instance, this kind of economic models for product line architectures define common software development costs, common software maintenance costs, and also the benefit if you are reusing some element, you don't need to, in an application, in many applications, you don't need to develop it n times, just one in the architecture. So this is the more or less the core of the economic model.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say that was tested in product lines architectural models.
And the other question is about the research question too.
Yeah.
I think you explained in the presentation the research question is not the same that.
Yeah, well, it was too long and I tried to shorten it.
But I'm not sure if both questions have the same meaning.
There, I think that I was saying how once adopted a software architecture, how can we ensure the suitability?
Yeah.
So it's by suitability, to evaluate the adequate work process of deriving concrete software architectures. But then I thought that it was obvious that the goal of reference architectures, and we said that is how to support the review.
Mm-hmm.
But I attempt to answer this.
Okay.
Are there
comments or questions?
Yes.
Okay.
No.
Bé, doncs si es deixeu, farem l'avaluació.